Well, for decades, former Wisconsin Senator William Proxmire made it his mission to track wasteful government spending. Ironically, the senator highlighted these agencies and organizations by granting them the Golden Fleece Award. Our next guest believes if Senator Proxmire were still alive, he'd have a lot to say about the government's current spending habits. Joining us now is founder and CEO of OpenTheBooks.com, Adam Andjewski. Adam, welcome back to the National Desk. Appreciate it. What kind of projects earned the senator's Golden Fleece Awards back in the day?
So back in the day, the good senator, he was a Democrat from Wisconsin, Bill Proxmire, he gets to Washington, D.C., and he sees that it's the Super Bowl of corruption with the wasteful spending, with the nonsense. And so he decides to do something about it. And so he comes up with this Golden Fleece Award. And for 14 years, between 1975 and 1988, he gives this award out, 170 of these awards. And some of the, you know, one of my favorite awards was in today's dollars, it would be about $400,000. It was a study by the FAA on how flight attendants arrange their knees when they sit, and they took the measurements of the length of their buttocks.
All right, well, that's a fine example of why the senator decided there was plenty that needed to have a light shined on it. You know, the senator passed away back in 2015, as you know, but you believe that if he were still alive, the senator would disapprove of plenty of projects that we've seen in recent years. What types of wasteful spending is currently taking place that you think he would really go after?
So, Scott, I give a Golden Fleece Award to Cornell University. They're an Ivy League college, and they took taxpayer money, $1 million, on a study where it hurts the most to be stung by a bee. It turns out it's the nostril. We actually read the study. It's a waste of $1 million. NASA, they gave a $1 million grant to prepare the nation's religions for the discovery of extraterrestrial life. Health and Human Services, they gave a $1.4 million grant for sex education to California prostitutes who could probably teach the class. And look, I would give a Golden Fleece Award right now to the Department of Labor. We know that at the height of the pandemic, there was 44 million Americans who lost their jobs. Unemployment insurance was supposed to help these people who have real needs, and now we know that up to $400 billion has been stolen from that program by con artists, criminals, and crime syndicates. It's the largest public fraud in the history of the country.
Any chance, Adam, that the Golden Fleece Awards are going to make a return? We haven't seen them since 2016, the last one, I believe.
So the mantle of Proxmire was picked up by our former honorary chairman, the late U.S. Senator Dr. Tom Coburn, who did his waste book reports and highlighted the waste, fraud, corruption, and abuse in Washington, D.C. And at OpenTheBooks.com, we're doing this on a daily basis at Real Clear Policy. You can follow along on hashtag Waste of the Day and also on our website at OpenTheBooks.com.
Since you were last here on the National Desk, President Joe Biden appointed Juneteenth a federal holiday. And while many people agree that that holiday was overdue, this is now the 44th paid day off for federal employees. Your organization, Open the Books, broke down the numbers. How much do federal holidays cost the average taxpayer?
So now with 44 days of paid time off for the average federal bureaucrat, Scott, that's nearly 9 weeks of paid time off. And we asked the question, is this France? Those 44 days of paid time off, we estimate, cost the American taxpayer every single year roughly $24 billion because you have to hire more people, your headcounts and the agencies have to be higher because everybody's got the day off. Here's how it breaks down. 11 federal holidays, 13 sick days, and 20 vacation days if you just work in your job at the federal government for 3 years.
Adam Andjewski, thank you so much for your time. We appreciate you joining us this Thursday morning on the National Desk.
Thank you, Scott.